Hey guys, one of my favorite things to do on New Year's Eve is work on cars. So as you can see, this beautiful hood is just so shiny now and so smooth and glossy. Now I was looking at that blower motor, I took it for a spin, and I've actually, diagnosed the blower motor. Let's get some light going here. Oh, come on, don't tell me this isn't working. All right. So let me show you, this is the problem here, the switch. So we're on three, you can hear that? Watch me go to four. Put a little pressure off it. See that? Let me just nudge it. Now let me just take a little pressure off it. See, it's a weird contact to number four. I can turn it on, watch this. It off like that. The contacts in this switch. It's not the blower, because that would last a lot longer until the blower overheated and shut it down. But it's this switch here. There we go. I turn it to four. It stops, nudge it, it comes on. I gotta order a switch. It's just like 30 bucks. So now that most of all the hard work's done, as I said, I did a lot of work on from here forward in the car for the paint. Then I kind of just half-assed the door from the door back to here. And I never even did the back because it's super hard to get to anyway. So I'm just going to, now that the hard part's done, I'm going to carefully do the doors real nice. I mean, they still have a good shine, but I want to just do one more coat on them. The back on each side, then I'll do the total rear back, then I might try and address this. I mean, there's all kinds of tricks, but I mean, these things are just pretty worn out and it's going to be hard to get them looking good. Another little trick I like to do, the seat belt is a little bit sticky, it stays down, it doesn't work good. Just go ahead and WD-40 up that puppy. Of course, put a rag there so you don't spray everything all over your seat. Got to get it in a downward position. There, now it pops right back up. Before, it would just stay in the down position every time I did it. So just lube that up a little bit. Everything you have to do with these old cars to freshen them up. Even the same thing for the door locks there. I wonder if I can push that just one hand. No, I'm gonna have to use two hands for that because this straw won't. And just spray out inside your door lock, then turn the key. It's going to really loosen it up on any of your older cars. Oh my god, what a difference. It just goes in like butter now. In, out, in, out, in, out. So smooth. So the final odd and end, I actually drove this in straight because the steering wheel is just a hair off over here. I need to move it right about 1 inch because of that lift. So first we're going to tape it off. Then what you're looking at, I believe, is called the track bar. This joint right here. And this you can turn with one hand to adjust your steering. Instead of the two tie rods on each end on normal cars, much harder. This is where the radiator blew and it got everything all dirty. So if I loosen these and turn this the right way, it's going to straighten the steering wheel automatically. It's not going to move the wheels. See, turn this, it's going to move the steering wheel. So you turn it a little and you go in and look and see if it's turning the right way, or you kind of figure out, you count the threads, but that can get real tricky because they're so hard to see. So I'm just going to go work on this a little bit. All right, I went up and over a full turn. So the black marks lined up again. I went this way, and it's worse the wrong direction. So I gotta loosen it, bring it back, and then do a much smaller change. So I have it right back where it was. Now instead of going up, which was the wrong direction, I want it just to go down maybe a half inch with my marks, if you can see them. Just a real slight. And I can always do it more later. but turning it a full turn the wrong direction brought it back the other way, but twice or three times as bad. So tiny little turns, just like every tie rod I work with, makes a big difference in the steering wheel. This should be just about right. It was just a hair off. Bring it right about there. Yeah, that adjustment didn't really help too much. It really needs a full alignment. That's just too much of a lift. A 6-inch lift just throws everything off so bad. Unless you're getting extended lower control arms for the front to fix that caster, that tiny tie rod thing just isn't working on the steering wheel. So it just needs a full alignment and maybe some helper suspension parts to kind of finish up. Got to leave something for the next guy to do, right?